We face now the last section of this topic.
In this section, we will analyze the economy in the short run, taking into account the goods and financial markets at the same time. We will also study the influence of the monetary and fiscal policy over the economy.
Let's start by putting the IS and LM graph together simultaneously and writing the mathematical formulas that represent the equilibrium in both markets. Equilibrium in the good market implies that if we increase interest rate, we reduce production. Equilibrium in the financial market means that if we increase income, we will increase the interest rate. When the IS and LM curve crosses, we will find the equilibrium simultaneously in both markets. Equilibrium may vary if we modify any variable that affects the IS or the LM curve. For instance, any variation in consumption, investment, public expenditure, taxes, monetary supply, or monetary demand will affect the equilibrium.
That's it. But what really worries me is, what kind of tools does the government have in order to improve the situation?
Government can intervene in the economy through what we call economic policy. The most important kinds are named fiscal and monetary policy. Could you tell us something about fiscal policy?
Certainly. Fiscal policy means that we can alter the economic equilibrium by increasing or decreasing public expenditure or taxes. When we talk about fiscal contraction or fiscal consolidation, what we're talking about is about reducing public deficit. This can be done in one of two ways. The government can increase taxes or can reduce public consumption. This will have a short-run effect on the economy of reducing production, reducing income, and reducing interest rates. On the other side, when we are talking about fiscal expansion, we are referring just the opposite. We are talking about increasing the public deficit, and this the government can do it in one of two ways, or reducing taxes or increasing public expenditure. This will have a short-term effect on economy of increasing production, increasing income, and also increasing interest rates.
So what is better, a fiscal contractionary or expansionary policy?
That is a very difficult question with a not easy answer. It really depends on what the government wants to do. Because in economy, when you do something in economy, you improve something, but you can create problems in another part of the economy. So we really don't know the final product of this improvement that we try to include in economy.
So you mean that expansionary fiscal policy would generate growth in the economy, but at the same time, public deficit, and on the contrary, a contractionary fiscal policy would produce an increment in the superavit, but contract the production, right?
That's it.
Where do we see it graphically?
Okay, I'll try. The fiscal policy affects the IS curve, not the LM curve, because we're considering taxes and public expenditure.
I see.
If the government increases taxes, people will have less money to spend. So we will see a reduction in consumption. So that will translate in a shift to the left in the IS curve. As a consequence of the fall of the production, the people will have less income, which will generate a reduction of the demand of money. Now the demand of money will become smaller than the supply, generating a reduction of the interest rate. The final consequences of the tax increment is a reduction of production, a reduction of income, and a reduction of interest rates in the economy. Do you know the effects of a tax increase over the private investment?
Well, if government increased taxes, you said that there were two consequences. First, a reduction of the production and income, and second, a reduction of the interest rate. A reduction in income will generate a reduction in the investment today. Simultaneously, a reduction of the interest rate will generate an increase of the investment. Taking both factors together, the investment may increase or decrease. So the effect is ambiguous.
That's it. We are not sure what is going to happen with investment as a result of an increase in taxes.
As you know, the monetary policy allows the government to modify the equilibrium by affecting the money supply. We will speak about contractionary monetary policy if the government reduces the amount of money in the economy, generating a reduction in the income and production and an increase of the interest rate simultaneously. On the other hand, we will speak about expansionary monetary policy if the government increases the amount of money in the economy. That would generate simultaneously an increment of the production and income and a reduction of the interest rates. Monetary policy affects the LM curve. The IS curve doesn't move. Could you help me to explain it with an example graphically, please?
Sure. Let's assume that the government decides to expand the amount of money in the economy. For example, buying bonds to commercial banks. The first consequence will be that money supply will be larger than money demand, and the interest rates will diminish to correct this disequilibrium in the monetary market. That means graphically a shift in the LM curve to the right. As a consequence of the interest rate reduction, companies will invest more. That will generate an increase of demand of goods, an increase of productions, and an increase of income in the economy. We are moving graphically from point A to point A prima. So to conclude, we may say that if the government follows a monetary expansionary policy, what will happen in the short run will be an increase in production, an increase in income, and a reduction in interest rates.
That sounds very interesting, but what I would like to know is what is the impact of that kind of policy over the investment. Let me explain it to you a little more in detail. An increase of income will generate more sales, and so an increment of the investment. Simultaneously, a reduction of the interest rate will generate an increment in the investment too. So, as a consequence of both factors together, the expansionary monetary policy will always generate with certainty an increment on the investment, making this a difference with respect to the fiscal policy.
That's it. We have just seen that the effect of fiscal policy over investment is ambiguous. But that is not the case with monetary policy.
Government may use different combination of fiscal and monetary policy to generate the desired effects over macroeconomic variables, like production and interest rate. But they want also to affect other important variables as trade balance, public deficit, or employment. The combination of fiscal and monetary policy is known as policy mix. In the following chart, you can see the different policies that the government may follow, fiscal and monetary, as well as the shift that they produce over the IS or LM curve, and the movements of production and interest rates.
The students now should practice the fiscal and monetary policies with the IS and LM curves in order to understand better its consequences.
Mastering the economic consequences of the government policy is one of the main issues of this topic. Government may have a great influence over the economy with its economic policy. With the fiscal policy, the government may affect the economy by modifying taxes or public expenditure. With the monetary policy, the government may influence the economy by modifying the money supply.
And now, you should answer the test of this section. Remember, you can do it just one time. and the grades will be part of your final marks.